everyone, and welcome to Feed and Green Chat. I'm your host, Elise Schaefer, editor of Feed and Green. This edition of Feed and Green Chat is brought to you by Watt Global Media and feedandgrain.com. Feedandgrain.com is your source for the latest news, product, and equipment information for the grain handling and feed manufacturing industry. Today, I'm joined on Zoom by Steve Beeney, Sales Territory Manager for CPM Beta Raven. He's here to share how you can optimize feed facility operations with automated systems. Hi, Steve. Thanks for joining me today.
Thank you. I appreciate the opportunity to join this chat.
Now, can you start by sharing why it's important to stay up to date with automation systems? And what are the downsides of using outdated hardware and software?
Well, I guess when it comes to keeping up to date, I think first about doing Windows updates, that they're pretty important on keeping your system up to date when it comes to security issues and so forth. So I definitely would recommend running Windows updates on a regular basis, but also just keeping your network devices up to date not only fixes known issues, but it makes the network more secure by patching any known security issues and so forth in that system software. But the other thing is having immutable backups in case there is some kind of ransomware attack. So again, keeping software up to date, but also having good backups of your software. The other thing in reference to software is just your control system software, such as, like in our case, the MillMaster software. It's best to keep the software up to date so it allows you to access any new features, but also prevents obsolescence. You don't want to fall too far behind to where you're several versions behind. If there's an issue with the system, you have to get the update before we can fix that new maybe issue that occurs. So keeping your software up to date is very important, both on the Windows side and your control system software. The other thing in reference to updates is the hardware issues. You want to keep that to where it's easy to support your system. For example, if you have, say, an example of a scale display that's still using something like DeviceNet or ControlNet instead of what everybody's normally using is Ethernet, you could have an issue, a simple issue, where maybe the scale technician needs to come out and put a new scale display in. But if you're still using that older technology, that board might not be available. So instead of being down for maybe an hour, now you're down for a day or multiple days because of using obsolete hardware. So yeah, it's very important to have both your software and hardware up to date.
Ooh, yeah, those are some good reasons. Now, can you give me some examples of how automation systems reduce paperwork and data entry? And how does this lead to operations improvements?
Well, there's a lot of things that can be done when it comes to reducing paperwork and data entry, but let's start out in, let's say, the receiving area as an example. We have a program called Data Exchange where we transfer data in and out of our system. And a lot of people don't think about it, but your purchase orders from your accounting system can be transferred automatically into your automation system. So that way, when the load is received, you can cross-reference to this purchase order. That handshake automatically occurs, and when that load is received, it goes back to your accounting system. So here you have an exchange of data, all electronic. No one had to fill out any paperwork or enter any data to say that that PO is received. So no need for the buyer that's in maybe an office across the street or up the road to see if a load's been received. They'll be automatically notified. Other ideas maybe for reducing paperwork would be using the control system to log when magnets and so forth have been cleaned, or maybe the elevator monitoring data. I've seen many places where they have a log book and the operator is supposed to write down when they clean the magnets. Well, let the control system do that by monitoring when it's been open. You can reset the timer, log a control point note in the system, and maybe the operator can even enter what he found on the magnet. So again, keeping it all electronic, no paperwork, and trying to reduce errors. Another thing is maybe doing the error permit report. I've seen where people have to manually log down their differential pressure sensors. Instead, you could have the control system monitor that and keep a report for you that's all electronic and can be printed out at any time. So just some simple areas there. Drug reconciliation, that can be done electronically as well. Maybe if you have a loss in weight micro system and then you're keeping track of your medications, historian could see when you load the bin with a new bag and log that, and you can monitor every batch that's been used out of it. So again, I've seen where people do drug reconciliations and they have to handwrite all this down. Instead, the control system could be doing that for you. Some other examples, loadout tickets. You can have your signature electronically put onto that ticket, and that ticket can be emailed to the end user. So instead of printing it all out and making 3 or 4 copies, you can email a copy and put a PDF copy in the accounting room. So, you know, all that electronically. Even something simple as the printing out sample bags, labels. So most people have a handwritten label that they, when they receive product or maybe when they ship product, this can be done through the control system where it just prints out a tag automatically. So the operator just grabs it and sticks it on there instead of handwriting it out, maybe even putting the wrong data on there. That is alleviated. Some other ways to reduce data entry would be to use more of the data exchange feature. It's a way of exchanging data into our system and out. So for maybe transfer your recipes, no need to key those in, your inventories, your usage and produced information, that can all be done electronically. Also, maybe write into a spreadsheet. I've seen people take their data that's printed out on a printout and go to an Excel spreadsheet and key it in, saying what they've made and some of their other stuff. Well, we actually have a way to export it directly to a spreadsheet, and you can do a SQL view and it'll auto-populate that spreadsheet. So you connect that spreadsheet to the database and it populates. So you don't have to key anything in. Maybe some other things is just getting your pellet process temperatures. Some places are making like a hygienic feed and they have to make sure that the temperature of the process is staying at a certain level for a particular run or feed type. That can automatically be exchanged and they don't have to handwrite any of that down. Another thing that I could see maybe reducing paperwork is cloud-based maintenance software. Become very popular. Imagine where the maintenance people get a work order through their mobile device and they can go out, do the maintenance, scan the barcode and automatically update the system. So again, no paperwork, reduced in errors and just easy tracking and so forth. So
certainly sounds like some time-saving benefits there. Now, what should facility managers consider for both their current needs and future needs when selecting an automation control system?
Well, there's a lot of things there. I think support is your biggest thing. There's many companies out there that can build a control system, but support now and into the future. And I would always ask around. There's a lot of other customers out there that are using systems. Ask around, ask how the support is with the company. But to me, that is most important. Features, I would say, ask, make sure that they can follow the features that you need. And I would even ask them, are there any features that other people are using that would be good for me? We do this every day, putting in new control systems, updating systems. So we should be able to provide you with some ideas and some better ways of producing better results. You want to find a company with good experience, plenty of experience that can provide references and say, hey, what are these guys like? But also just review your future IO needs. I mean, it's not hard to expand a control system, but it is kind of nice to prepare them. For example, if you're going to add another pellet line in the future, you want to make sure that you got enough space for the IO or network ports or server space. Are we going to need another workstation and so forth? It's nice to know that up front, but future IO requirements. But the other thing is non-proprietary hardware. you want to make sure you have something that you can get parts at any nearby electronic parts supplier. You don't have to buy from the control system vendor. If you're in an emergency, it's a Friday night and you need a part, it's nice to be able to get it locally. So those are some of the things that I would say need to be considered.
Looking into the future, how might artificial intelligence, cloud-based systems, and remote monitoring benefit grain and feed facility operators?
Well, I would say cloud-based systems can be used to gather data from multiple facilities and integrate this data into a remote monitoring system so that the plant manager could, or really a division manager, could compare his facilities all in one location. So remote monitoring can provide a dashboard to this division manager showing how each facility is doing, their throughput, maybe their downtime, and so forth. Also, getting back to what I mentioned earlier, that cloud-based backup storage would be perfect for those immutable backups. They're very important, and having them off-site is also important. But getting to a web API interface is also a newer feature that uses a good way to transfer files in and out of our system via the web. This would replace that local transfer file system that everybody's normally used to. So again, using the cloud, using the web, and for those type of things. But you mentioned artificial intelligence. I would think the AI is going to be a big part of our future. I see a perfect opportunity where a system could self-tune itself using the parameters and the results from previous runs to tune up your batching system or its pelleting system. But I also could see AI helping reduce operator mistakes by seeing abnormalities earlier in the process. Also improve plant efficiency and basically providing better predictive maintenance data.
Well, we certainly look forward to the development of that. Well, thank you so much for your insights today, Steve. And if you'd like to learn more about what Steve talked about here today, visit cpm.net. That's all for today's Feed and Grain Chat. If you'd like to see more videos like this, subscribe to our YouTube channel, sign up for the Industry Watch daily e-newsletter, or go to feedandgrain.com and search for videos. Thank you again for watching, and we hope to see you next time.